dear students, how are you all? I hope you all are fine. So welcome back to our biology class, and we are looking for the lesson that is management of the natural resources. Actually, this lesson is belonging from the environmental science. This is included into the biology that I have to teach, but this lesson is originally, or basically this lesson is designed from the environmental science. See students, various vague questions, tricky, twisted questions are mostly asked into the board exam based on these three lessons, which are last, that is natural resources, our environment and management of natural resources. So students, it's my kind request to you all, please do not neglect to this lesson. Line by line, read this lesson as well as some other extra material which will be provided by me to you all. Please go through that and just give a proper justice for this lesson. Okay, so without wasting much time, I would like to start my lesson, that is management of the natural resources. See students, ancient Indian text, there are four major ancient Indian texts are there, that is Yajurveda, Samveda, Atharvaveda and Rugveda. Among these four, there is one Atharvaveda, ancient Indian text, and in that Maha Upanishad is also a one integral part of this. In that Maha Upanishad, it is written that Vasudhaiva Kutumbakam. You might have heard this Sanskrit phrase various times. What does it mean, Vasudhaiva Kutumbakam? Can you give me the answer of this question? What does it mean? It means that entire earth is our family. The whole entire earth is our family, and in family we are living in a harmony. This is not new for you all, right? We all, both natural resources and we, are the integral part of the family, and we both are depend on each other, and we are living in a harmony. From lower classes, from earlier classes, we are having focus on it, how we are depend on each other. Last year also you have learned that in the natural resources lesson, understood? So we are the integral part of the family, as well as these resources are also the integral part of the family, and our activities affects on each other. That also we have seen. Actually, our whole activities, means especially I'm talking about all mankind, human beings, since ancient times, our whole activities, our customs, our rituals, our traditions, our long lasting traditions, everything, our craft, as well as our festivals, our food even, everything is according to the nature. Means we are behaving according to the nature. Okay, we are behaving according to the nature, means we are trying to live our life along with the natural resources. So here we are going to talk about some natural resources and how we have to manage them and why we have to manage them. What is the need to manage them? Okay, why over exploitation should not be taken place. So today is our topic, is the natural resources. Okay, resource, first of all I would like to clear the concept of the resource. What is mean by resource? The things which are useful for us is said to be resource. Resource means what, students? The things which are useful for us, okay, means which we use them, which supports our life, those are called as a resource. See, this is the board, which is resource. This is a marker. This is resource. The camera on which I am recording this video is a resource. This light, everything is resource. Now for you, what might be the resource? Your camera, your laptop or your TV screen can be the resource. Means the things which we use in our daily life is said to be resources. And the things which are no longer of our use is said to be waste. Okay. In last topic, I have cleared this concept. Resource means what? The things which supports our life. The things which are useful for us is said to be resource, and the things which are not at all useful for us is called as a waste. Okay, so here in this topic we are going to talk about some natural resources. There are various kinds of natural resources. What are those, students? Yes, can you guess some? You can, I know. Natural resources, which are those? Air, on which oxygen is the integral part of the air, on which we are depend. Air, water, right? Soil, right? Temperature even, solar, sunlight, okay? These all are coming into the natural resources, okay? These are very much important part of the resources that are natural resources, okay? And the artificial or man-made resources are what? So this board which we have made by using some natural resources, so this can be included into the artificial resources. This is the marker, man-made. This benches on which you sit, that is man-made resources. Means this is made from the natural resources, but this is made by the human beings. Understood? So this is called as a man-made resources, or we can say as a artificial resources. So here I hope your concept is clear of natural resources and man-made resources, and the concept of resources even. Okay, so natural resources, mainly in this topic, management of natural resources, in this topic we are going to have focus on two major natural resources, that is forest and wildlife, that is forest and wildlife, and another, that is water. So mainly in this lesson we are going to have focus more on two major natural resources, that is forest and wildlife and water. Other resources are important, but in earlier classes we have tried to complete them and we have seen them in detail, okay, along with the cycles, oxygen cycle, carbon cycle, along with it we have tried to complete or trying to learn more about them, about those resources. But here in the class 10 standard we are going to have focus on this two resources, that is forest and wildlife and the water, okay. So these resources are also mainly divided into two types, students. What are those? Exhaustible resources. Exhaustible. Exhaustible resources. What is mean by exhaustible resources? Means the resources which are getting tired. No, it is not the proper meaning. The resources which are present into the limited amount. Okay, the resources which are present into the limited amount, okay, which cannot be replenished or cannot be recharged again, such resources are called as a exhaustible resources, okay, means which are going to finish once. After some period of time these resources are going to be finished. Can you guess those resources? Okay, correct. The correct answer is coal and petroleum are the exhaustible resources. These are going to finish very soon. You know the life of the coal? Coal will survive more 200 years, and petroleum products, all petroleum products will be for only 50 years, next 50 years. But if you will use, if you will exploit it in a more amount, then it can finish earlier also. Understood? So coal and petroleum is the example of the exhaustible resources, okay. So exhaustible resources are what? Limited resources which cannot be replenished, which cannot be recharged again, okay. So those are coal and petroleum, means which are in the limited amount on the earth, okay. So after finishing them, what would happen, students? Then our turn would be there to form coal and petroleum. You are knowing the formation of the coal and petroleum. For the next generation, if coal and petroleum would require, then it would be our turn now to become a coal and petroleum for the next generation, okay. So exhaustible resources are present into the limited amount, which cannot be replenished, which cannot be recharged, and the example for it, coal and petroleum, which is commonly called as a fossil fuels, okay, because which we get from the fossils, so it is called as a fossil fuels. So these are the exhaustible resources, okay. Then the another point, if exhaustible resources are present, then what are the inexhaustible resources? Inexhaustible resources means what then? Inexhaustible resources means what? Which are unlimited. Which are unlimited. Means which are present into the abundant form. Abundance means what? In a more amount, okay. Abundance. Abundance is the more exact or more proper word for this inexhaustible. Means which can be recharged, which can be replenished again. What is the example for it? Water, correct? Water, air. Water, air can come in it, okay. Soil, Soil takes a lot time to replenish. Soil takes to a lot time to replenish. Okay, but soil also comes into the inexhaustible resources. Okay, so soil is the example, water is the example, air is the example. Means the resources which are never going to be finished, which are unlimited in the environment, which are abundant into the environment. Forest and wildlife also can come, means forests can come in it. But formation of the forest is the lengthy process. Okay, so based on it, there are two other types of the resources, that is renewable resources and non-renewable resources. Renewable resources means what? Renewable resources can comes in it. Inexhaustible means which we can get back. We can reuse them. We can utilize them again and again. Renewable resources. Okay. Another type is non-renewable resources, which actually you will learn more in our natural resources lesson. In that you will come to know. There is one specific lesson designed for the resources, that is natural resources. So non-renewable resources means what? Which we cannot get back them. Okay. So that is related to the renewable resources and non-renewable resources. So here I have finished with the natural resources, means the introductory part of this management of the natural resources. Tomorrow we will go ahead for the further topic. Thank you.